boy.
Okay, that's going in the journal. I bet this will lead out.
Atreus, to me.
It's locked magically.
Go!
Okay, well, that's way too far to jump. This'll be fun. Almost there! I can't jump over with those wooden boards in the way. Different runes written along the side of this one.
What does it say?
Another riddle. Feed me not, we both are doomed. Overfeed me, all consumed.
The answer might be near, like the other.
I see it now. It says fire. Of course. Bow. gonna see what's up ahead. How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. Or what it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie.
Say.
Sir. They turn new things upon all the trust.
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. Death to the Raven God, Lord of the Hang. Another one of those sandals.
What does it say?
Falcon, hawk, and turtle dove. Swim aloft in oceans above.
Those runes on the rock.
They don't spell anything. It's gibberish. I'm sure we'll find the answer around here somewhere.
Atreus, here.
Yes, Father.
Here, boy.
Oh, the rest of the runes were hidden over the hill. That's Vinder. When?
Back to the sand bowl.
Sir. Vinder. Look what it did! Father, she is here. It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. Now, what's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Pamela! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well, thankfully his head hasn't decayed much and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him.
Here, boy.
I know those runes. That's Vinder. Wind. Must be for that sand bowl down there. Sir. Vina. Look what it did! Father, she is here. It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. What's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Hey, Melin. It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well, thankfully his head hasn't decayed much and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir? You there?
Yes.
Good.
Oh. Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the witch in the woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either? Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are God.
Leader of the Vanir, once, yes. But no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
What?
Now.
You're welcome.
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your counsel, Head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Who better to tell us the way?
The world serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
That's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
Why did Freya spin your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, a spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
Hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're on the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
You never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin?
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
Mimir, you were in the middle of a story before. Why would Freya agree to marry Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story. Thank you.
can read what this says now. But it's a name.
Gerdrifor.
Whoa! The name made it light up.
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. Or I can just tell you this story later.
Another name.
Air!
Another Valkyrie. It's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers?
Saying something about love and hate being...
intertwined, yes. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Jorgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Jorgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted against this bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I could scarcely recall them all. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally, that horn!
I put my lips. Probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
Remembers me. Travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
That one of the people we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment.
Now that, you thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there. I don't think we should disturb Jormungandr without some reason. There's really no call for that at this point. I don't think we should disturb Jormungandr without some reason.
Alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him.
So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
No earthly key nor physical force can get past the magic of that lock. Don't even look at it.
Never seen a lock like that before.
Reminds me of something I've seen Tyr sketch. He liked to combine various symbols into runes all his own. This one, I believe, means...
peace, unity, mercy. Other things too. I see what he did, but how do we get inside?
We have other concerns.
We'll need something to get through this one.
Which way to the chisel?
Boat under the bridge, keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
So what was it like when Odin and Freya got married?
The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice he would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
We could beach the boat here.
Focus up, boy.
Thank you. should look for more like this. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Well, I can just tell you the story later.
Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than hers.
After so much time together, she knew her vulnerabilities and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of a warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. World this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
Getting in there without a key. Entire city under the water.
Aye, lad. A forgotten city.
What was it called?
Well, I forgot.
we'll take him down together. Take him down together.
Need more time!
Tears, braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it, he wouldn't.
Oh!
Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it, he wouldn't.
We've seen these runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read. That's an interesting gate. I wonder who built it. The mirror. There was a shrine about a giant lady. Lots of books and visions.
Well, I can just tell you the story later.
Something to get through this one.
Atreus, to me!
I'm coming, I'm coming!
Locked up good.
Focused.
Yeah.
Atreus, to me.
Thank you.
Focus up, boy.
Straight out of hell.
Atreus, to me.
Mirror. There was a shrine about a giant lady with lots of books and visions.
Ah, that would be Groa, the knowledge keeper. But I can just tell you the story later.
Come on!
answered the language cipher.
Good.
Of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir Storm Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Hey, lads! Of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon. His penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Thank you.
changed since we last crossed paths. His legs. You wee little bugger. Well, the running dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Boy, over here.
Huh, neat.
Huh.
there. What awful pest. Impressive!
Look here.
Sir. Treasure map. All right.
I have a favor to ask. Just a small favor, really. Do you remember the dagger you gave me?
The dagger stabbed into the Reaver's back? His own son killed him? Yeah, I haven't forgotten that one.
Well, I traced it to a group of Reavers that operate out of the Northree stronghold. I'd wager that's where they took their haul from Fafnir's storeroom, along with that whetstone that I could use to help you.
Another treasure hunt? Pointless.
Well, not if Sindri really can make us better equipment with that whetstone. Plus, the Reaver's son. He murdered his father. Hey, Sindri.
The travelers. Oh, disgusting. Smelly, covered in God knows how many little beasties, but gorgeous armor. Let's see if I can't make something more sanitary. Yes? I can do whatever you need. piece of work. If I say so. Myself. And for you? What shall it be? And for the youngster? Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
Right then, I just started a story earlier concerning Groa, the Knowledge Keeper. She was a gifted sorceress who gathered every tome of arcane wisdom she could find in the realms, all in the hopes of augmenting her powers of prophecy that she might find her lost husband, Arvandil. And we'll pick this up later.
Vermeer, you were in the middle of the story before.
Groa the sorceress assembled a library of arcane knowledge, hoping to increase her prophetic powers to find her lost husband. And we'll pick this up later.
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all. Get started then. Oh, nothing. Okay.
What is this place?
Could it be? The Eight Thrones.
Stop being coy, Ed. Do you know this place or not?
I'm Mimir, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
To who? There is little of value here.
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
Groa the sorceress assembled a library of arcane knowledge, hoping to increase her prophetic powers to find her lost husband. But it was not her husband she would glimpse in her visions, for it was Groa, seeing longer and farther than any before or since, who witnessed Ragnarok, the end and the beginning. And we'll pick this up later.
You who walks among the living! My beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her book.
Good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once, named Thamlo. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, He caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see. Hammer fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.